Hello humans, this is Dr. Kai, and may I present to you the mysterious and exciting TRAPPIST-1 system. This system has been dominating the science and astronomy news as of late, and is a pretty rare case where it's actually about something of genuine interest. Three worlds that are in the star's habitable zone have been known for a while, but four more worlds have now been found in the system. The system itself was discovered in 1999 using the 2-micron all-sky survey, TUMAS for short. And later in 2015, the Belgian team at the University of Liège discovered three planets, all in the star's habitable zone, using the TRAPPIST telescope, which stands for Transiting Planets and Planetesimal Small Telescope, at the La Silla Observatory in Chile. The method uses a technique called transit photometry, which measures the dimming of the star as the much smaller and directly undetectable planets pass in front of it to discover them. A truly worldwide effort culminated in another four planets being discovered, utilizing, among others, the NASA Spitzer Space Telescope and the Very Large Telescope. It now holds the record for the system with the most known exoplanets, and being named after a Belgian beer, itself named after the Trappist contemplative religious sect, seems pretty damn awesome if you ask me. So here is an artist's impression of the system, which we can visit in great detail in Space Engine. There are also plenty of artist's impressions online, and all of them really help to make this solid and real in our minds, rather than a distant set of statistics and graphs. For a link on how to install it on Space Engine and where to get it, see the description. So first things first, I want to note how small this system is compared to our own. The furthest planet only takes 3 weeks to orbit the star, which explains why we were able to see them all in a reasonable time. Here you can see where the Earth's orbit would be in this system. The fact that some of these planets are in the star's habitable zone just goes to show how cool TRAPPIST-1 actually is. And yes, I mean cool in both senses. Being an ultra-cool dwarf M-class star, the coolest type of main sequence star, and the very cool end of that star type too, an M8, with only an M9 being cooler, this star is frigid compared to our Sun. It is approximately 8% of the mass of the Sun, and barely 11% of the radius. So if our Sun were replaced by the TRAPPIST-1 star, it would look like this. I've kept the brightness simulation at normal, so this is pretty much what it would look like. We would be living on an ice ball if this were the case. The good thing about the cooler stars, especially the really cool ones, is that they are stable and long-lived. TRAPPIST-1 could be as old as the galaxy, and will live on for up to a trillion years. That's a truly unfathomable, epic, deep time figure. Plenty of time for literally tens of thousands of civilizations to develop and crumble, with enough time between each one for them to totally lose any record of the ones that came before. There could be a civilization on TRAPPIST-1e right now that is the 10th so far, and it has no idea of any of the others that came before it due to the billion years of erosion and plate tectonics covering up the evidence. But I get ahead of myself. Another cool thing about M-class stars is that they don't have a lot of damaging radiation like UV rays or worse, so life is much more likely to be found around them than even stars similar to our own Sun. These cool stars do have one drawback though, and that is that because the orbits of the habitable zone planets are so close to the star, there is a very strong chance they are tidally locked, or at least in some harmonic rotation period with a very long day and night. If they are tidally locked, which is most likely, they will have one side permanently facing the star and one side permanently dark and cold. But we don't really know much about habitability in general. It is presumed that this will be a big strain on life developing. As you can see, it can lead to huge cyclonic weather patterns like this, which, while striking, can be quite damaging to the ecosystems and, well, who knows. The author of this system in Space Engine has put all of the planets as being tidally locked. He has created the first planet as a warm oceana, or a water world, a world with little or no landmass. The atmospheric pressure is 1.86 times Earth's, although the gravity is only 72% of Earth's. The temperature here is 96 degrees Celsius. Isn't quite boiling point, which would be 116 degrees in this pressure. From inside the atmosphere, it looks like this, with a striking large red sun visible through the thick atmosphere. Lots of the glare is lost, and the cells and sunspots are visible. The second planet is the opposite. All land and no water, and classed as a warm desert planet. It is about the diameter of Earth, but quite a bit more massive, giving it a gravity of 1.2 times Earth's. The atmosphere is very thin, so the surface temperature of 59 degrees Celsius is actually above water's boiling point. The star is barely visible through the very bright permanent cyclone in the atmosphere, and overall, it is a hot, sticky red world that glares and will not be very pleasant. The red tint though is beautiful. TRAPPIST-1d, the third planet, is the first that has both land and liquid water on its surface, being the first planet in the star's habitable zone. It wouldn't be very pleasant for humans at all, even if it had oxygen in its atmosphere, as it has an atmosphere of only 2.6% as pressurized as Earth, which would cause our blood vessels to burst and, well, maybe our heads would explode. That being said, it's quite warm. With a surface temperature of 15 degrees C, a degree or two above Earth. The thin atmosphere leads to minimal weather, and only a very low ruddy pink tint of the sky at the horizon, which tapers to black. It is a fairly red world like Mars, and the other planets can all be seen, even in a daytime sky. TRAPPIST-1e is rated by the Planetary Habitability Laboratory Study, try saying that when you're drunk on TRAPPIST, as being the second most habitable exoplanet that we know of, the first being Proxima Centauri b, which, as a side note, is amazing. It's around the closest star to our sun. The closest star to our sun has a planet that is potentially habitable. Just let that sink in. I'm going to make a video all about that. It has an Earth similarity index of 0.86. With Earth being 1 and Mars being 0.64, this could very potentially be the home to life, especially over the course of a trillion years. The author of this system in Space Engine hasn't gone to great lengths to make it habitable though. First of all, the atmosphere is even thinner than TRAPPIST-1d at 0.8% the pressure of Earth, not much more than the vacuum of space. It is also completely frigid at minus 24 degrees C. Whether some exotic form of life could exist here or not is not for us to know, but we certainly wouldn't like it if we arrived after a million year voyage of discovery. That isn't going to be liquid water on the surface either, rather it's ammonia, so this could be home for ammonia based life. This planet has a very wispy red sky, and the star again is a red ruby casting its light all over the featureless surface. The last habitable planet is much colder, with a not much better atmosphere, and would certainly not be a good home for life. It does have noticeable weather though. 1g has a huge atmosphere at 58 atmospheres of pressure, and this leads it to being extremely hot, with a huge greenhouse effect. It's a bit like Venus, a stifling burning world, but it has nothing but liquid water all over its surface, prevented from boiling over at 144 degrees by the huge pressure of the atmosphere. It has no sulfuric acid in its atmosphere, so unlike Venus, it wouldn't have any stinging acid rain, and could very well be home for some sort of life in its vast oceans. TRAPPIST-1h is a frozen ice world, with barely any atmosphere to speak of, and a temperature of minus 112 degrees C, completely inhospitable. Already at this distance, the star appears smaller than our sun in the sky, even though it is 15 times closer to it than we are to the sun. And that ends my little tour of the system. Being 39 light years away, TRAPPIST-1 is extremely close, relatively speaking, and this journey shows that there aren't many stars between us and TRAPPIST-1. It is way too far and too dim to see with the naked eye. You'd have to be well within 2 light years to even see it. It is cooler and dimmer than our closest star, Proxima Centauri, and we can't see that with the naked eye. If we had sent Voyager 2, which left our solar system, to it, it would take 750,000 years to arrive. It's close, yet so far. But it's a real place, something we've managed to touch in some way, to connect to in some way, to turn into something real, with incredible techniques and collaboration. And maybe someone there has pointed a telescope at us, discovered our planet, and is connecting to us in the same way. So long, humans.